in this article we have to find the section of a sphere by plane. Here we have to prove that section of a sphere x square plus y square plus z square plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d is equal to 0 by a plane lx plus ly plus nz is equal to p is a circle. And also we have to find the radius and center of the circle. So first we draw here a sphere 1. Suppose that this is the sphere and here O be the origin, O be the center of the sphere whose coordinates are minus u, minus v, minus w. So let us suppose that let O minus u, minus v, minus w be the center of sphere 1. And here we suppose that this is the plane, this is the plane second, here this is the plane second, suppose this is plane Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to P, this is the given plane. Here we draw perpendicular OC from the center of a sphere O on the plane. Here let C be the foot of perpendicular, C be the foot of perpendicular, C be the foot of the perpendicular drawn from center of a sphere, center of a sphere O to the plane, to the plane second. Here suppose that this is the sphere, O is the center of the sphere, and we know that if the sphere is x square plus y square plus z square plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d is equal to 0, then coordinate of the center of the sphere be minus u, minus v, minus w. This is the plane Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to P. Here this OC is the perpendicular drawn from the center of the sphere on the plane Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to P. Here C be the foot of the perpendicular drawn from the center of the sphere. Now we join this and suppose that this is the section of the sphere and by the plane. Let A be any point on the section, let A be any point on the section of a sphere 1 by the plane second. Here we suppose that A be any point on the section of a sphere by the given plane second. Now join here OC, join here CA, and CA is perpendicular to OC. Join CA and CA is perpendicular, CA is perpendicular on OC. Here we can see that this is the given sphere, x square plus y square plus z square plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d is equal to 0. And we know that the coordinate of the center of this sphere 1 is minus u, minus v, minus w. Let us suppose that this is the plane second, Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to P. Now, OC is the perpendicular drawn from center of the sphere on this given plane second. Here C be the foot of the perpendicular drawn from the center of the sphere O on the plane. Let us suppose that this is the section of the sphere by the plane. So we suppose that A be any point on this section. Join C and A, that is CA, and we can see that CA is perpendicular to OC. Also we join this OA, and OA is the radius of the sphere. OA is the radius of sphere. OA is radius of sphere, and we know that radius of sphere is under root u square plus v square plus w square minus d. Now we find here OC. OC is the length of perpendicular. OC is length of perpendicular. OC is length of perpendicular drawn from center of sphere to the plane second. Here we can see from the figure this OC is perpendicular drawn from the center of sphere 1 on the plane second. So now we find here OC. So OC is equal to L multiplied by minus U plus M multiplied by minus V plus N multiplied by minus W and minus P divided by under root L square plus M square plus N square. Replacing X, Y, Z in equation of plane Lx plus My plus Nz is equal to P by minus U minus V minus W. We replace X by minus U, Y by minus V and Z by minus W, and divide by under root L square plus M square plus N square and get the perpendicular distance OC. Now this can be also written as OC is equal to minus LU minus MV minus NW minus P divided by under root L square plus M square plus N square. Now we find here CA. From the figure we can see that here CA square, this is equal to OA square minus OC square. Here we find that this CA is perpendicular on OC, so this is the right angle triangle. So using Pythagoras theorem here, we find here CA square is equal to OA square minus OC square. Here OA is the radius of the sphere and OC is the perpendicular distance from the center of the sphere on the plane. So both are constant, so CA square is also constant. Here CA square is equal to constant because OA and OC both are constant. Here we can see that this CA is constant because here OA and OC both are constant. OA is the radius of the given sphere 1, so it is constant, and OC is the perpendicular distance from the center of the given sphere 1 to the given plane second. So both are constant, so difference of this OA and OC, OA square and OC square are also constant, so CA square is constant. This shows that CA is also constant because CA square is constant, so CA is constant. CA is constant. Here CA is constant here. here CA is constant, we can see here this CA square is difference of OA square minus OC square, and OA is the radius of the sphere, so it is constant, and OC is the length of perpendicular drawn from the center of the sphere to the plane second, so this is also constant. So difference of OA square minus OC square is constant, that means CA square is constant, so CA is also constant. Now we can see here, A B A point at a constant distance, from C, let A be a point, on the section of sphere. A be a point on the section of a sphere at a constant distance from C, section of a sphere by plane at a constant distance from C. So locus of a point is the locus of a point is the circle. We know that circle is the locus of a point whose distance from fixed point is always constant. Here we can see that CA is constant, that means A is the point on the section of the sphere by the plane, and the distance of this point A from fixed point C is constant, that is CA is constant. So section of the sphere by the plane is a circle. So let A be a point on the section of a sphere by plane at a constant distance from C. So locus of a point capital A is the circle. And here C is the center. And CA is the radius of the circle. Since we know that circle is the locus of a point, locus of a moving point whose distance from a fixed point is always constant. Here A is the point on the section of the sphere 1 by the plane second, and distance of this point A from the fixed point C is constant, that means locus of point C is a circle, and this C point is called the center of the circle, and this CA distance is called the radius of the circle. So locus of point A is the circle. Thank you.